Hey there, I'm Allison from Slideform. Today, let's talk about how you can easily automate export of charts and data and even KPIs out of Looker Studio into your recurring presentations and client reports. So here's a Looker Studio dashboard, just a demonstration project using Google Analytics data. Now, each week, let's say that you needed to create a client deck like this with weekly performance metrics like the numbers of views, sessions, and different charts and tables from your Looker Studio dashboard. Now, the old way to do this might be copying and pasting screenshots and typing in the numbers. But luckily, Slideform is here to help you automatically create all of these reports on a schedule. So let's take a look at how you set that up. In Slideform, there are really three different pieces that you need in order to pull the project together. First, you have to connect your data source, the Looker Studio dashboard, into Slideform using our integration platform. Secondly, you need some sort of template in Google Slides or PowerPoint that's going to control the layout and flow of your report. And third, you just link the data into that report. So let's walk through the process. First of all, we'll connect the data source. In data sources, you have the option to add any number of different data sources, and you can combine data from multiple data sources in one report. To add the Looker Studio integration, you just need to share your dashboard with us, share at slideform.co, and enter the dashboard URL into Slideform. Then once you save that, Slideform will index the information and store it so that you can have it ready to go into your reports. Let's take a look at what Slideform has captured from my Google Analytics dashboard. If you want to embed charts, you can preview those and select them and send them over to your reports right here. So for this dashboard, you can see we capture a full screenshot of the entire page, as well as screenshots of each individual element on the page. Those might be charts, tables, or even scorecard elements like this. Now, what makes Slideform special is that we also capture the data behind each of those dashboard elements. So for example, if we wanted to extract the number of views from the scorecard metric and embed that into our presentation as an actual number, we can extract the number of views for this past week or the change from the prior week and embed those as numbers as well. So let's take a look now. We have our data source set up. Let's take a look now at our template that controls the slide deck itself. If you start out with a slide deck like this, maybe from last week or last month for a given client, to create a template, what you need to do is simply replace everything that's going to change between versions of the report with these curly braces, which show us that this is going to be a placeholder that's going to be replaced when Slideform fills in the information. So for example, for the number of views in a given time period, we have a placeholder here that's just in a text box. For a chart, we have a placeholder that's inside of a shape. So you would insert a shape in Google Slides. It doesn't have to be a rectangle, any shape, and we'll fill it in with the chart from your dashboard. In addition, if you wanted to fill in a data table, you could also create that, and we'll fill in a data table that's completely editable with the numbers from your dashboard. Slideform also supports images, text, words that you might just type in, and we have a lot of built-in functions representing page numbers and date ranges. So once you have your slide deck template ready to go, we go back into Slideform and you can create a new project. To do that, you just upload the Google Slides, or you can integrate Google Drive and select your template out of Google Drive. Once that's read in, it's going to create a little card like these that you see on the page, and each one of them is a different project or template. to get into there and complete the third step of setup, you need to configure data. And that means you're going to connect the data to the template. So for a project that's already had its template saved, you're going to see a page like this, where we can set up all of the different data mappings. So for example, let's take a look at that number of views that we had in any given week. We are going to pull this number in as text into the presentation. So to do that, I need to preset the value and indicate that it is going to come from our Looker Studio dashboard. Then we simply select that we're going to use one of the tables, and we select the sheet and the table that we're interested in. Then we need to choose which column that data is in, and make sure that we get the first value from that table. If you're ever wondering what kind of data connection you have, you can always preview the number before you go ahead and send it to the data, to the slides. What's nice about Slideform is you can also set formatting for any of these numbers. So in this case, it's just a number, but if we had percentages or numeric currency values, you can always use our formatting to make sure that number will show up the right way in your presentation. Now to pull in a chart, we can just look at our sessions over time chart. This is the one that's going to be right here, showing the number of sessions each day compared to the prior time period. So to preset that, it's a very simple process. We just select our dashboard, our worksheet, and our chart. And that is going to be anchored into the center of that rectangular placeholder. And again, you can always preview the data to make sure you choose the correct chart. So now if this all looks correct, the last thing that we need to think about is probably filtering the dashboard. Of course, if you go to the Looker Studio dashboard, you can filter by the date range or by any other filters that you have, but Slideform makes it so much easier to control the filtering from within Slideform. So if we wanted to pull in the prior week, every time we run this presentation, it's gonna pull the data from the last prior week. We just set a project filter with the date range to prior week. If you wanted to filter any of these individual charts to select only certain categories of data, or maybe you have a different date range for some charts rather than others, you can always set an individual filter just on that one chart. Finally, you just save the output, and then in order to generate, we hit the blue button here to generate. Now the nice thing about Slideform is that you don't have to wait for the output. You can have the output sent to you by email, or you can save it to a Google Drive. You can save PowerPoints to your OneDrive or any other shared drive. And you can also schedule those outputs so that you don't even have to log into Slideform or think about it. You just receive the report delivered to you in the format that you prefer. So here's a preview of our report for the prior week. It looks great. And so you can save that manually here into Google Slides, PowerPoint, PDF, or just share it using our own built-in slide share. We save it to Google Slides, and you're going to be able to see that report show up here under your list of all downloads. So let's take a look at the output. Now with Slideform, we have a lot of advanced features, such as enabling you to embed text and numbers and format those numbers. You can also extract the data behind a chart. So for example, this data table does not actually appear on the dashboard, but it is extracted from behind this chart down here, this pie chart. So if you needed to get any of the numbers here that are going into that chart, you can get it into your presentation. In addition, our output is very flexible. you can actually share a presentation template between multiple clients, and you can use Slideform's bulk mode to actually generate multiple presentations all at the same time for different clients, different filter values, different date ranges, or whatever kind of variable you need to. So I hope that this has been informative and it shows you really how far advanced Slideform has come since the last time we talked. So thank you so much for listening. Reach out at slideform.co.